Let's add this potentiometer to analog input 1 so it can control the speed of the drive by rotating a knob instead of using the up-down arrows on the keypad. I'm using a CFW100 for this video. The CFW100 drives don't have an analog input on the base drive, so we have to add an option module with an analog input. I'm using this one, but you can use any module you want that has an analog input. The CFW300 has an analog input on the base drive, but since it is analog input 1, everything we do in this video, minus adding an option module, will apply directly to the CFW300 family of drives too. I wired this potentiometer to analog input 1 like this. I'll apply power to the drive. Let's go to parameter 204 and set it to a 5 to reset the drive parameters to factory default, just so we're all starting in the same place. Now, you wouldn't do that if you have an existing configuration you're trying to modify. First, we need to go to parameter 231 to tell the drive we're using analog input 1 as a speed reference. According to the manual, we need a 0 for that. And as it turns out, that's the default, so we're good to go there. Next, we need to go to parameter 233 to tell the drive we're using the analog input as a 0 to 10 volt signal. The manual tells me that needs to be a 0, and again, that's the default value for this drive, so we're good to go there. To verify we did all of that correctly, we can go to parameter 18, which shows us the value the drive sees on analog input 1. Rotate the potentiometer, and sure enough, full counterclockwise gives me a 0 reading, and full clockwise gives me 100%. Perfect. I'm going to put that back at 0 so we don't get any surprises when we connect that to the motor. Now, if you used analog input 2, then you would use parameter 19 to view the potentiometer value. Great. We now know we wired things up correctly and that the drive sees the potentiometer on analog input 1. And we really haven't done anything yet because all of these were default values for this configuration. But don't assume that. Always check those parameters just to be sure they're what you expect. So, the only thing left to do is tell the drive to use the potentiometer on analog input 1 and not the keypad to control the frequency of the drive, which will control the speed of the motor. To do that, we go to parameter 221 because we're using the drive in local mode. You would use parameter 222 if you're setting us up in remote mode. The programming manual says we need to enter a 3 to tell the drive to use the potentiometer, but that's the potentiometer on the potentiometer option module, which has its own dedicated configuration. We're using a potentiometer on analog input 1, so we need to enter a 1 for parameter 221 to tell the drive to get a speed reference from analog input 1. So all we did was wire the potentiometer to the analog voltage input and change one parameter. I'm going to scroll back to parameter 2 so we can see the drive's frequency, and double check that the potentiometer is all the way counterclockwise, which we know is 0. I'll hit run, and the drive goes to its min speed, which we can change in parameter 133. If I rotate the potentiometer, sure enough, the drive frequency changes. If I rotate it all the way clockwise, the drive goes to the max speed, which we can change in parameter 134. We can change parameters 100 and 101 to change the acceleration and deceleration to make the potentiometer feel more responsive if we want to. We're not going to do that here. Well, that's all there is to controlling a drive with a potentiometer. Now, if you want to use the analog input for some other process like PID, then the WEG drives also have parameters that allow you to massage the analog input to optimize it for your process. This little drive is packed full of high-end features like this, which is what makes it such an amazing value. Again, we have lots of videos showing you how to get the most out of your WEG variable frequency drives. So, click here to learn more about the WEG family of variable frequency drives. Click here to learn about Automation Direct's free support options, and click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we publish new videos.